So in my last video, we talked about making rhythmic patterns using a sequencer. We were using the Q960 with the Q963, and using the switches on the Q963, we were able to make patterns rather than just a straight eight. Well, what if you don't have a 960 or a 963? What if you have the Q119? Can it be done on that? Actually, you can make patterns using any 3x8 sequencer, which there's a number of them out there. Let's take a look at the Q19 and see how we can do it on that one. Okay, so we have our Q119 set up as a 3x8. So we're going to run a sequence off of the first row, and it sounds like this. We have two spare rows. What we normally need to create a pattern is to be able to gate something on and off, but to be able to select which step that gate on and off occurs. The gate output, let's say we take the bottom row, is going to hit on every note, so that's not good. But the CV, if we turn one up, one down, one up, one down, we're actually creating gates, because up means it goes up to 5 volts, down means it goes down to zero. Gate goes up to 5 volts, down to zero. So we're creating gates on specific steps when we do that. What we could do is we could take, we'll just try it. We'll take the CV output, which is our gate, and I'm going to plug this into a envelope generator. Okay, and this, let's see if this will work. So, gate, not a gate, gate, not a gate, 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 not a gate. Here's the problem. We have three in a row that are gate, which the problem is going to be that the gate comes up on this one and it stays up until it gets to this one and drops back down. Well, that's only going to key once, because the envelope generator needs to see a gate start and stop, start and stop. It never stops here. So you'll notice it's not triggering on these. How can we get that to trigger? I'm going to discuss the Q156 comparator. Now, this is an interesting module. It's got a comparator on the top. It's got three extra modules, a mixer, an LFO, and a VCA. Very, very handy module. You can use it for different things. But what I was thinking was, if we could take the CV and mix it with that gate, because the gate is going to go up, down, up, down, up, down every time. What would that do? Would that help? So let's try it. Let's take the gate, and I'm going to go into the mixer on the comparator. Now, there's a difference between this mixer and a regular mixer that you have on your synthesizer, and this is a AC coupler mixer. So we're not literally mixing these signals together with DC. We're mixing them with AC. So anyway, let's see what that sounds like. Mixing those two together. Okay. Actually works. So we're mixing the gate with the CV that we're creating. So let's just verify. We'll turn all these down except one, and we should get no gating. Just turn on the first one. Okay, see what's happening? We're getting additional gates. Because it's reacting to the gate signal. So, since we're using the comparator, it turns out that if we take this mixer output and go into the comparator, come out of that, now go into our envelope generator. So you have a threshold adjustment here, and when the every time the input goes above that threshold, you get a gate. If it goes down past it, nothing. But every time it goes above it, you get a gate. Well, it turns out by adding that, we can now... They're keying exactly where we want them. Isn't that cool? Okay, so creating patterns on a 3x8 sequencer, the Q119, using the Q156. I kind of found that trick by accident. I was using the 156 for a whole different project, and that's coming up in the future. Also, you might have noticed we didn't use the second row on the sequencer, and I do intend to use that. And probably the next video will show you a trick with that. So stay tuned. Appreciate you guys coming and watching these videos. If you're getting anything from them, hit the like button, share it with your friends, and we'll catch you next time.